What we need to do is identify people who have expressed some kind of interest. It's far easier for us to continue to have a conversation with someone and frankly sell to someone who has expressed interest. If we look at the pages or the content that they've already seen, that is expressing an interest in a particular topic, potentially even a product or a sale. Just because someone says no doesn't mean they're saying no forever. It means they're saying no, not right now.
Hey there, funnel builders. Mike Killen here from Sell Your Service. If you are a funnel builder, go ahead and click subscribe because I produce new videos like this every single week, helping funnel builders like you sell more marketing funnels.
If I put a product page, and we see this all the time, of course, because we sell courses and coaching. If I sell those courses and sell those coaching, we probably get anywhere between 20 to 100 people visiting our sales pages and checkout pages every single day. And a certain percentage of them convert, and a certain percentage don't. But those that don't aren't not converting. It's a bit of a double negative there. But they're not converting because they don't like it. They're expressing an interest in it. They're just not ready for it right now. And remember, at the start, we talked about this 0-day truth that on average, people need 11 different touch points and roughly 7 hours worth of time, the salesperson or the product creator or whatever, and through four different channels. It might be that they simply haven't seen it enough. We think in terms of broad logical steps, which is dangerous for a start anyway. But we think in broad logical steps that surely if a product is put in front of someone, that they will want to buy it, yes or no. 10% of people, 5%, 1%, 0.1%, whatever the conversion is, if we put a product in front of 1,000 people and one person buys, that means that person is going to buy and everyone else is not interested. We think, well, surely if they're interested, they're going to buy it straight away. Are there any products or services that you've been wanting to buy for a while now and you think I'm sold on it? I know that I want to buy it, but you just haven't got round to clicking the buy now button. My Amazon cart and wishlist is full of products like that. I think I for whatever reason, I don't want to buy it just yet. We know that this is true. And if we repeatedly follow up with customers and prospects and continue to make that offer to them, think about what we're doing. First of all, we're demonstrating that the product has got legs. It's got lifespan. It's going to be around. It's not a fly by night. There are so many products out there, particularly digital products and services, that don't even exist in 6 months' time. Only the other week, a colleague of mine, Cam, he sent over a course for a guy who was selling how to sell a marketing funnel to customers or how to build a marketing funnel for customers. I'm not specific. I think it's how to sell, actually. He sent me the link and he went, "Look, man, someone's entering your space, so to speak." And I was like, "Okay, cool, let's go ahead and check this out." And I went through it and I was like, "This is interesting. It's funny how people are doing this." And I reached out to the guy, never heard back from him, and then went back and checked, and it had stopped 6 months after it started. We live in a time now where apps and products and courses and digital content and services and companies are so easy to set up that they don't even have the lifespan to be around. So we're now more wary than ever. We think, if I do invest in this, is it even going to be around in 12 months' time? Is it even going to be around in 6 months' time? And it requires a level of trust to be built from you, the provider, to demonstrate, yeah, we're going to be here. We're not going anywhere. There's also a concept called percolation, similar to coffee. We have a product land in the top of our mind. It takes a little while for it to root, go through our subconscious and be turned into a product that we're comfortable with and that we desire and that we see in our everyday life. Yes, there are absolutely occasions, of course, where you will put a product in front of someone and all the copy is right and all the content is right and the benefits are clear and you have a good spec sheet and the results are clear and then you go into the deliverables and the features and they love that and they go, "Yeah, I want to buy this," and they buy because they trust you. That is rarer than people who are more likely to buy after continuing follow-up. And I can prove this. In fact, I'm going to show you, we're going to build this out together. I'm not advertising at all on Facebook right now because I wanted to build this in real time with you guys and go through this process with you. But we can literally see that if someone reads, it's usually between 7 and 12 emails to do with selling it. two or three sales pages, maybe a sales video. They'll typically jump on one or two webinars before they make a purchase. Over time, that takes a while, of course, but the content stacks up. And now we see more sales on automation than ever than just running launches. Capitalize on early birds, people who want to, or early adopters, I should say, people who want to buy something straight away. But that's not where the majority of your revenue will come from. The majority of your revenue will come from people who have seen the offer multiple times. They've had 11 different touch points with you through 4 different channels. And this is on average. It's a balancing act. You've spent 7 hours worth of time with you, or read 7 hours worth of your content or whatever. Listen to you for 7 hours. We see this happening now. So that's what we're going to build out. So we want to identify a group of people who have expressed interest. If someone has landed on your contact form, that to me is an expression of interest that they're interested in contacting you and getting in contact with you. It sounds obvious, but that's the person we should be capitalizing on. If they land on a sales page for a product, it's a pretty good indicator that they're interested in that product. Them not buying is not them saying, no, I don't want it. It's saying, you simply haven't done enough yet to convince me to buy. That's it. And they are the closest people to a conversion. The people who are in your audience who have never seen your offer are not the closest to a conversion. Massive mistake. They're not the closest to a conversion. They might be at some point, and yeah, a few people within that audience who are just like a really well-built audience, they might be. But the people who have expressed an interest are closer to a conversion, even if they've said no. Someone who has said no to an offer is actually closer to a conversion than someone who's never seen the offer before.
Guys, thank you very much for watching. Massively appreciate it. Make sure to hit subscribe and the bell icon and all that kind of stuff. See you on the next video. Have courage, commit, and take action.